23. Peak. Well, from the bouncing, you might be able to tell. I'm driving around Troy's truck, and he put a lightning style right side double exit exhaust. So it's actually very quiet. Well, quiet for what it is, much quieter than before. Especially under boost. And fixed all the exhaust leaks. We were all so tired of working on it, he gave it to his buddy, Chris Lloyd. And what he ended up doing was RTVing everything and throwing away the gaskets. This truck kept burning out exhaust manifold gaskets, which is odd. I really have never had that problem before. So I don't know if we warped it accidentally or it's a manifold. It's not a cast iron manifold. So maybe we warped it because we couldn't get a gasket on it to save our lives. So now that it's not leaking out of the manifold and everywhere else, making a little bit better boost, which I saw a peak of 23. We'll see if that's true or not. Don't know if I can trust that. I just want to roll into it a bunch of times, see what the air fuel is. I already took some out. It's gonna rain. Looks like it is raining over there. It's awesome to drive around this truck. It's got AC blowing right now. Blasting. I'm like almost freezing in shorts and a t-shirt. And it's pretty shitty outside for this area. Very humid. Fast. I'd like to pull maybe 5% more of fuel, maybe not. Is that like a 10.7? Pull 2%? Bounces like crazy. You could never cruise this for a really long time. It just gets on your nerves. I don't know, maybe some of you people that drive Hondas that bounce like shit every day can deal with this, but no thank you. I'd rather not. Yeah, 23 pounds, that's nice. It's got a little bit of a lean spot there off idle, but what I found out, and maybe some of you might have some suggestions, but honestly, if you have a tiny bit of a lean spot off idle and you try to fix it, you get on the highway and you cruise and you're right about the same spot and it's fat. So as long as it doesn't bog or annoy the shit out of you, sometimes I just leave the fucking lean spot right off idle. Like you can see it goes 16.0, and really you don't really notice it power wise. It's not like the truck feels like shit. Sometimes you can hear it, it sounds a little funny, but. This is a shit place to make a left. Like 12% of fuel, because the highest we actually got the truck to before, like messing around, it was about 17, and it kept dropping off. But that's because the manifold leak got worse and worse. So now that the manifold leak is gone, you know, runs 23 pounds. So it feels nice and clean now. I took fuel out before, yeah, 23 psi. I took fuel out before I even rolled into it, because Troy told me it was just 10-0 coughing its brains out on fuel. So I hit it with 10% immediately in the 20-pound area. I could see where the numbers were higher than the others, so. See how I can do from a semi-slow roll. Yo, just skating a little bit. Hard throttle, skating rink going on. Crazy how quiet it is now. Almost all you hear is the turbo. And the AC is blowing. Cold as fuck. How fast this thing gets over 100 from a roll like that. It's flat out impressive. It has some boogie, that's for sure. I hope that comes out on video. From like a 50 mile an hour roll, it's just like, I have it set to not downshift, so it doesn't just blitz the tires in second. So you just roll up into the converter in third, and it just piles on the speed to a point where you're like, man, am I gonna have trouble slowing down? Jesus. I probably won't be able to get on it again with all these fucking people in front of me. Pavers. Ruts are terrible. Well, boys, that's all.